Determine the temperature of refrigerant 134A vapor that has a specific volume of 0.016 cubic meters per kilogram at 1.6 megapascals by using the generalized compressibility chart with the ideal gas equation and then the tables. To make the most out of this exercise, remember to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the ideal gas and compressibility factor 11-minute lecture video. The links to the other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. Based on what we learned during the main lecture video, we can use the ideal gas equation for non-ideal gases like this refrigerant if we account for compressibility with the compressibility factor Z. This means that T equal PV over RZ. We have the pressure and the specific volume, and we can easily look up the gas constant for R134A. All we're missing is that compressibility factor Z. To find it, we'll make use of our charts. In this case, we have the pressure and the specific volume. This means that we can calculate our reduced pressure as P over critical P, and our reduced volume as the specific volume times P critical over R times T critical. We look up the critical pressure and temperature of refrigerant 134A, and with those, calculate the reduced pressure and the reduced volume. These two values will be the numbers we enter our compressibility chart with. This means that we are not going to use the same chart that we used in the example from the main lecture video. That one is only used when we have temperature and pressure values. The chart that we'll use here is the second version we showed then. And since the reduced pressure is between 0 and 1, we'll use the first of the two charts we have for this version, basically the zoomed-in version of it. For an axis value of 0.394, which is basically between 0.39 and 0.40, and a diagonal value for reduced volume of 2.13, which is a little bit farther than halfway between 2.00 and 2.20, we find that the Z factor is close to 0.84. We substitute this value in our initial expression, and we find that the temperature is 374 Kelvin, or 100.83 Celsius. If we were to find this using the tables, we will look up the superheated table for R134A, we'd go to a pressure of 1.6 megapascals, and look for a specific volume of 0.016. We technically need to interpolate here, but since this value is so close, we'll just assume that the temperature is indeed just shy of 100 degrees Celsius. If you want to check out the other examples for this same topic, the main lecture video, or other lectures of the thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!